Hi everyone, today we can discuss the business analytics. There are huge amount of data which has been recorded, Facebook, Amazon, Twitter, Netflix, etc. There is an emerging concept you might have heard about, that is surveillance capitalism. So that is a debatable topic right now. So business analytics helps for the business managers for taking better decisions. So that the business analytics is a technique which has been popular right now. So the topic for discussion under business analytics consists of the business analytics meaning and definitions, and the types of business analytics or the scope of business analytics and the challenges faced by the business analytics. Business analytics is the use of data, information, technology, statistical analysis and quantitative methods and mathematical and computer-based models to help the managers gain improved insight about their business operations and for taking business decisions. So it's a combination of technology, statistics, quantitative methods and business models which helps the managers for taking better decisions with the help of the analyzing of the past data. So it is a process of transforming data into actions through a better analytics. It has been supported by various tools such as Microsoft Excel and Excel add-ins and commercial software packages like SAS, Minitab, R package, Python, etc. A lot of or a wide variety of decisions can be taken with the help of business analytics. For instance, pricing. So we can set the prices for consumer product as well as industrial products, and we can fix the prices in government contracts and maintenance contracts, etc., through business analytics. And apart from that, customer segmentation. For example, identifying and targeting key customer groups in retail segments, insurance and credit card industries are widely used business analytics for for identification of customers or customer segments. And merchandising, for example, determining the brands to buy, quantities and allocations, that is a focus point. They are using business analytics for that. And the location preferences, also business analytics has been widely used. For example, finding the best location for bank branches and ATMs. Also where to serve industrial equipment. These all decisions can be taken with the help of business analytics. This slide shows the visual perspective of business analytics. And you can see statistics is a part of business analytics, and the business analytics using simulation and risk analysis and what if analysis. Modeling and optimization is used, data mining, business intelligence and information systems. So there are a lot of components which have been using for proper business analytics. So this slide experiencing these components such as statistics, data mining, visualization, simulation and risk, what if analysis, modernization and optimization, business intelligence, etc. So the scope of business analytics. Business analytics contains three types of analytics: descriptive analytics, predictive analytics and prescriptive analytics. These three analytics are the major scope of business analytics, or the people using business analytics for descriptive analytics purpose, sometimes for prediction and sometimes for prescriptive analytics. So we will discuss all these components in the later stages. So the types of analytics, again, the descriptive, which focus on what happened, means it's fully based on the past data and the describing the past data. So next is predictive analytics, which focus on what might happen in the future based on the past data. These analysis also using the past data. Then the prescriptive analytics, what should we do? Because there are situations in which we need to find the appropriate decisions. There are a lot of decisions can be taken, but we have to limit one decision due to some limiting factors. So that situations we can be able to use prescriptive analytics. So this descriptive analytics, it is a review of business performance to find problems or areas of opportunity and identify patterns and trends in data. So you know, it is based on the past data. Typical questions that descriptive analytics helps to find out the answers are: how much did we sell in each region? That means for a sales department, they have sales turnover for a particular period of time. So that organization may think about how much did we sell in each region. Region-wise analysis can be done with the help of business analytics. And what was our revenue and profit last quarter? So they have to identify the revenue and profit or losses for the last quarter, that they can use the business analytics. Then how many and what types of complaints did we resolve? Because in sales department, they might have got many complaints from the customer service. So what much they are successful for resolving the complaints of customers, that can be understand through business analytics. And which factory has the lowest productivity, that also they can be done through business analytics. So next is predictive analytics. Predictive analytics seeks to predict the future by examining the historical or past data. And you know, the past data having some patterns, the following the past data may following some trends or relationship. So that can be a learning experience for prediction of the future things. So for example, a marketer might wish to predict the response of different customer segments to an advertising campaign. Of course, once the company has done some advertisement, so the amount spent for the advertisement shall be justified through the sales. So what amount of sales can be reached through that advertising campaign can be checked through business analytics. And a commodities trader might wish to predict short-term movements in commodities prices. This can be also done through business analytics. For instance, a bank manager might want to identify the most profitable customers or predict the chances that a loan applicant will default customers. That can be also be undertaken through business analytics. So this business analytics will help the companies to alert a credit card customer to a potential fraudulent charge. And predictive analytics helps to predict risk in the future time period. So risk can be predicted, default customers, credit card customers can be predicted, and profitable customers can be predicted, and default loanees can be predicted, and a future of advertisement campaign can be predicted. These all can be predicted with the help of predictive analytics techniques, which is a part of business analytics. So next is prescriptive analytics. Prescriptive analytics uses optimization models or optimization techniques to identify the best alternative to minimize or maximize some objective. So prescriptive analytics is used in many areas of business, including operations, marketing, and finance. For example, we may determine the best pricing and advertising strategy to maximize revenue, the optimal amount of cash to store in ATM, or the best mix of investments in a retirement portfolio to manage risk. So prescriptive analytics address all these questions because this cannot be done through predictive analytics or descriptive analytics, because we have a lot of alternatives, but we have to select one best alternative because of some limiting factors. So the questions which addresses are: how much should we produce to maximize profit? What is the best way of shipping goods from our factories to minimize cost? Should we change our plans if a natural disaster closes a supplier's factory? So, if so, by how much? These questions can be answered through prescriptive analytics. This slide again closely distinguishes predictive analytics and prescriptive analytics. Predictive modeling uses mathematical spreadsheet and statistical models and address questions such as what impact on loan volume will a given marketing program have? How many processes or underwriters are needed for a given loan volume? Will a given process change reduce cycle time? But the prescriptive analytics involves the use of simulation or optimization to drive decisions. The questions include what is the optimal staffing to achieve a given profitability constrained by a fixed cycle time? What is the optimal product mix to maximize profit constrained by fixed staffing? So the answers or the questions addresses by the prescriptive analytics and predictive analytics are different. So there are three analytics we used in business analytics, like descriptive analytics, predictive analytics, and prescriptive analytics. Descriptive analysis just focus on the describing the past data, but predictive analytics, the past data will lead for the future prediction, but the prescriptive analytics is optimization models. This slide shows the business analytics cycle. First of all, we have to understand the business scenario, business situation, whether the data will be appropriate, what is the situation in which the business is going on. Definitely, if we want to do business analytics, such kind of thing is the first step in the process. That step is called business understanding, and this next step is analytic approach. An approach shall be selected, and the third one is data requirements. So we need data for the purpose of business analytics, how we can collect the data, and the data collection is the next one. And next is data understanding the data. Data may be different type, cross-sectional data, time series data, and panel data. So understand the characteristics and nature of the data. And the data preparation, that means some kind of unstructured data, maybe we are getting some kind of unstructured or unstructured data, that time we need to structure the data or clean the data. So that stage is called data preparation, and after that we can model it based on the appropriate models available, and we can evaluate, we can deployment and feedback. Everything, the feedback again come back to modeling, and again we need to remodel it if the model is not fit. So this is the cycle of business analytics. There are skills are required for business analytics. Of course, coding is very important. The skills acquired become a business analytics professional include in-depth knowledge of R is very important, and Python coding, MS Excel. So we can do simple analytics through MS Excel, and the mathematics expertise. You know, mathematics is very important for business analytics and business strategy acumen. There are challenges faced by the business analytics, like data need cleaning. I already explained that the data may be unstructured, so we need to clean the data. Sometimes the data volumes are growing fast, means we are collecting the minutes to minutes, seconds to second big data, so that times the data volumes are growing fast. So there is a study by IBM, and they explained 90% data in the world which has been created in the last 2 years, because that shows, that itself shows the huge volume of data in nowadays. And if you use analytics with bad data, the results are useless. So these are the challenges of business analytics. So this slide shows the garbage in and garbage out. If we use the bad data for the purpose of analytics, the result may not be useful, and the useless result may be the outcome when we use the bad data for business analytics. So first of all, the organization think about doing business analytics, and they have to check the data collected, and the data are good informs, and whether that data is analyzable or not. So that is very important. First of all, they have to check the data, and whether the data is good or correct one, then they can do analysis, and that analysis will be a fruitful one. This slide shows the data is much more unstructured. It does not all comes from relational database or spreadsheet. So it cannot be in the form of a spreadsheet or the relational databases. Data may be in the form of PDF, MP3, JPG, XLS, MOV and DOQ documents. So we need to structure it. That is very important.